Hello children, we'll start with chapter number 12, which is identities. Now starting with the very first identity, we have a plus b, a minus b, which results in a square minus b square. Now this means we have two brackets where the first value as well as the second value is same. In one we have a plus sign and in the other one we have a minus sign. We'll start with exercise 12.1. The question is finding the products. I've just randomly chosen some parts. Now we have 7 minus 2 by 3x and 7 plus 2 by 3x. So we have to see which identity it is related to. It's related to a minus b, a plus b. If the question looks like this, the answer must be in the form of a square minus b square. So what is the value of a and what is the value of b? The first term is a and the second one is b. So finding the square of first minus the second, 7 square is 49 minus 2 square is 4 and x square is x and 3 square is 9. That's the answer. So next one, xy plus 3, xy minus 3. Again using the same identity, the value of a is xy and the value of b is 3. So square of a and square of b. And when we are squaring xy, we have to square x as well as y separately. And minus x square y square minus 9. The next one, 1.3x plus 1.9y, and again same value with minus sign, again using the same identity, a plus b, a minus b, squaring the first minus squaring the second one, and the result will be 1.69x square minus 3.6y square. Then we have xy square plus xy x square y. In one there is a plus sign, other there is a minus sign. Again you have to see which identity it is related to. Yes, it's related to a plus b, a minus b only. This is a and the second term is b. So squaring the first one as well as squaring the second one. So if there are two different variables, you have to square them separately. Squaring x, we get x square, and y square is already a square. So y square ka square means when one base has two powers, both the powers are multiplied, it becomes y4. Same thing we'll do on the other side. X has two powers, 2 and 2 out, 2 in, 2 out, 2 2's a 4. Same goes for y, and this is the answer. Now, we have a question where we have 1, 2 and 3 brackets. Now if we see the first and the second bracket, it's in the form of a plus b, a minus b. So we'll use the identity for the first two brackets, and after solving the first two brackets we get the answer as a4 b4 minus x4 y4. Now we'll combine this answer with the third bracket because it's the same, only in one there is a plus sign and in the other one there is a minus sign. Like we get minus here and that's plus sign here. So now again using the same identity, a plus b, a minus b, squaring the first term as well as squaring the second term, answer is a8b8 minus x8y8. Now finding the product using a plus b, a minus b, which results in a square minus b square, but the question is not in the form of a plus b. So what we have to do, we have to split the first term as well as the second term in the form of a plus b, a minus b. So this becomes as 200 plus 7, this becomes as 200 minus 7. Like you have to split in such a way that the first term as well as the second term is same. In one you have a plus sign and in the other one you have a minus sign. The value of a is 200 and the value of b is 7. So squaring the first minus squaring the second, and the answer is 39951. Same goes for this part also. 1.07 into 0.93, taking common 1 where 0.7 is being added and in the other 0.07 is being subtracted, using a plus b, a minus b, squaring the first minus squaring the second, answer is 0.0051. Now we move on to the second exercise. Here we'll be using the identity a plus b whole square. Like question will be in this form, two terms in one bracket with either a plus sign or a minus sign and squaring it up. So the result will be a square plus b square plus 2ab when it is plus, and a square plus b square minus 2ab when it is minus. So 4x plus 7 by y whole square. So please mention which identity you are using, a square plus b square plus 2ab. A square means squaring 4, squaring x, plus squaring 7, squaring y. 2ab means first you multiply all the numbers, 2 4s are 8 and 8 7s are 56. X into y is xy. That's the answer. Next one again, the same thing, only the difference is it's a fractional term. So a square plus b square and plus 2 into a into b. So squaring the numerator, squaring the denominator and squaring the variable. Same goes for the second term also. 2ab means 2 into 2, multiply all the numerators, 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12 and 3 4s are 12, and then after that you can cut or you can directly cut it here. So and the result is this gets cut and we are left with only xy. Now it's a root question and identity will be obviously same, only the value of a, the value of b. So a square plus b square plus 2 into a into b. Now how to do it? दिस इज एक्चुअली अंडर रूट टू एक्स होल स्क्वायर मीन्स स्क्वायरिंग अंडर रूट टू ऑल्सो एंड वेन वी हैव टू विद स्क्वायर एंड अ रूट द स्क्वायर एंड द रूट गेट्स कट एंड वी आर लेफ्ट विद ओनली टू एंड स्क्वायरिंग एक्स बिकम्स एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस थ्री स्क्वायर इज नाइन एंड वाई स्क्वायर इज वाई स्क्वायर प्लस टू इंटू ए इंटू बी मीन्स वेन वी हैव नंबर्स विद रूट एज वेल एज नंबर्स विदाउट रूट द नंबर्स विच डू नॉट हैव रूट आर मल्टीप्लाइड सेपरेटली एंड द रूट नंबर्स आर मल्टीप्लाइड सेपरेटली एंड लिटरल्स आर मल्टीप्लाइड सेपरेटली टू थ्री इज सिक्स अंडर रूट टू एक्स वाई अगेन ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर मैंशनिंग द आइडेंटिटी ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी सो अंडर रूट टू होल स्क्वायर इज टू एक्स स्क्वायर इज एक्स स्क्वायर एंड थ्री स्क्वायर इज नाइन अब हेयर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट like this term see how to solve it squaring 2 squaring root 5 and squaring y separately because there are three different terms so 2 ka square becomes 4 and root 5 ka square is root and square gets cut we are left with 5 and y square so 2 ka square 4 4 into 5 is 20 so here we'll have 20 y square and here multiply the outer term separately 2 2 is a 4 and under root 2 and under root 5 will be under root 10 and denominator is 3 x y Again, if you have 203 whole square, first of all, write it in the form of a plus b or a minus b. So, I am writing it as 200 plus 3 whole square and then a square plus b square plus 2ab. So, squaring a, squaring b and 2 into a into b, the answer is 41209. Now, moving on to the minus identity, the question, the result will remain, result will be different, the identity will remain same only. A square plus B square and we'll have only have minus 2AB. So root 3X whole square is root 3 ka square will be 3, X square will be X square plus root 5 ka square will be 5 and Y square will be Y square and 2 into A into B. So out of the root we have only 2 and under the root we have 3 and 5. So multiply the under root terms together 3 and 5 is 15 XY. The next part is also same only it's a fractional part. Now, when they say write as a perfect square, this is your question number 15. This is the result. Now, the result is given. We have to write it in the question form. See the first term. This is 16x square and this is 36y square. 16 is a square of 4 and x square is a square of x. 36 is a square of 6 and y square is a square of y. So, that's a and this is b. And if the question is given in a square 2ab and b square form, the result should be in a plus b whole square. So, a plus b whole square. That's the answer. And only with minus, when it is minus, the only difference will be towards the end, you'll only put a minus sign. Now we have the third exercise where a plus b is given, ab is given. You have to find square of a square plus b square. So a square plus b square means you have to use the identity a plus b whole square. First mention the identity, then pick up the values. A plus b value is 4. 4 square is equal to a square b square remains as it is. 2ab means 2 multiplied by the value of ab. So this is 16, this is 2, 3 is a 6. Shift this 6 to the other side, it becomes minus. And the value of a square plus b square, which we have to find, is equal to 10. The next is also same. It's only the difference is that now we have a minus identity. So we'll be using, the minus value is given. We have ab and we have to find the square of a square plus b square. It's exactly the same, so we have not done this. In the next question, we have a square b square as 25, ab as 12. And we have to find the value of a plus b. If it is a plus b, use the identity of a plus b. Putting the values, whatever is given, a square b square is given as 25, 2ab is 2 and the value of ab is 12. So this is 49. Now this is a plus b whole square where we have to find only a plus b. Removing this square, putting it on the other side becomes root. So the value of ab is under root 49 which is equal to 7. And if we have to find minus, again the rule remains same. Do it in the same way. The only difference is, in place of plus int, we'll be using the minus int. And here 25 minus 2ab, 25 minus 24 is 1. And this again, a minus b ka value dhoondne ke liye, you remove the square, becomes root. And under root 1 is equal to 1. We've written plus or minus because it can be plus 1 or a minus 1. Now, this is question 3. We have x plus 1 by x as 7. We have to find the square of x square and 1 by x square. Same use, because this is plus wala, so same use. Use the same identity a plus b whole square mentioning the identity and putting the value here the value of a will be x and the value of b will be 1 by x putting the values and the result will be 47 now x square plus 1 by x square is given we have to find x minus 1 by x so I'm going to use x minus 1 by x whole square identity that is a minus b whole square a square plus b square minus 2 into ab putting the values in the identity and after cutting we get it 81, removing the square under root 81, and the value is plus and minus 9. This chapter finishes here. Thank you.